Hello, everyone. Welcome to the 700 Club. The Republican presidential candidates are facing off in another debate tonight in Miami, this less than a week before the crucial Florida primary. Donald Trump is leading in the polls there. And now GOP hopeful Ted Cruz says he thinks the reason why is because the liberal media is intentionally boosting Trump. Cruz explained his thoughts in an exclusive interview with our David Brody.
While candidates like Ted Cruz and Marco Rubio campaign in the key state of Florida, frontrunner Donald Trump marches to the beat of his own drum. He held a rally this evening in North Carolina because Tar Heel voters also go to the polls on Tuesday.
Do you pledge that on Tuesday you will go and we will make America great again and you will vote for Donald Trump? Yes?
Trump returns to Florida tonight, where polls show him solidly ahead. Well, if he takes this winner-take-all state, he'll be hard to catch. In Miami Thursday, Ted Cruz preached his constitutional conservatism in front of hundreds of enthusiastic supporters. They got even more excited when former GOP candidate Carly Fiorina joined him on the stage. Fiorina loudly backed Cruz and his anti-GOP establishment message.
When the establishment says Ted Cruz is too conservative, he's too much of a fighter, he won't get along, I say, you go, Ted.
Cruz is less than 100 delegates behind Trump and wants to take on the front runner.
And as this race continues and continues to narrow into a clear two-man race, head-to-head, Donald Trump loses. And loses badly.
In an exclusive interview with CBN News, Cruz criticized the liberal media for helping Donald Trump rise to almost rock star status.
You wonder when you turn your TV on why Donald Trump is on from the first thing in the morning till midnight. It's because the network execs, who are partisan Democrats, have decided, let's get Donald nominated, because once we do, Hillary wins.
Cruz is hoping to take on Donald Trump one-on-one. And as for Marco Rubio, he's just hoping to stay in the race because the reality is this. If he doesn't win his home state of Florida, it's all but over.
Rubio's campaign is struggling to gain traction here, and they're denying rumors now that he might pull out of the race before Tuesday's primary. Rubio was having none of it.
And so if anyone calls you and anyone tells you, oh, Marco Rubio's getting out, you tell them you heard it from me. They are lying to you. We are going to work as hard as it takes because we are going to win Florida and we will win the nomination.
But right now, that nomination is Trump's to lose. And that's why tonight's debate becomes even more crucial for the three remaining candidates trying to knock off Trump and a nervous Republican Party, too. David Brody, CBN News in Miami, Florida.
Well, it remains to be seen what happens with all of that. I mean, if for some reason Rubio cannot pull off winning his state, that will certainly change up the numbers, and we'll have to see where that leads. In the meantime, we get to enjoy another debate tonight. Well, you can see more of David Brody's exclusive interview with Ted Cruz on the Brody File on CBNNews.com. The frontrunner in the Democratic presidential race is also facing some tough questions. Wendy Griffith has that story from the CBN newsroom. Wendy?
Thanks, Terry. Hillary Clinton says she isn't worried about her ongoing email problems. And in last night's Democratic debate, she said she wouldn't even answer a question about the possibility of being indicted after saying she did nothing wrong.
I did not send or receive any emails marked classified at the time. I am not worried about it, and no Democrat or American should be either.
If you get indicted, would you drop out?
Oh, for goodness, that is not going to happen. I'm not even answering that question.
His opponent Bernie Sanders has not addressed the email controversy in the past, and he would not do it last night either. Well, a recent raid by U.S. Special Forces has led to a major breakthrough in the war against ISIS. They captured a key Islamic State chemical weapons operative, and he's confirmed that ISIS is using sulfur mustard gas against the people of Iraq and Syria. Our Gary Lane brings us that story.
U.S. Special Forces captured the head of the Islamic State's chemical weapons development program last month in northern Iraq. Sulaiman Daoud Al-Afari once worked for Saddam Hussein, specializing in chemical and biological weapons production. He provided U.S. officials with valuable intelligence about how the Islamic State had weaponized sulfur mustard gas and loaded it into artillery shells. The information led to U.S. airstrikes like this one against suspected chemical weapon sites near Mosul. Despite the newly obtained intelligence, the Iraqi defense minister denies that ISIS is using mustard gas in Iraq.
The Islamic State doesn't have chemical weapons. They sometimes use chlorine gas, which is ineffective chemically, but they use it more. By using chlorine, ISIS tries to affect the morale of Iraqi soldiers, but we are ready to repulse and defeat them.
But in recent weeks, CBN News has reported information verifying the newly obtained intelligence. In mid-February, we first reported confirmation of ISIS chemical weapons use. The Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons said soil samples it had obtained tested positive for sulfur mustard gas. The following week, CBN News military correspondent Chuck Holton, on the front lines in northern Iraq, showed evidence of chemical-laden mortar shells. One Kurdish soldier victimized by a gas attack collapsed in front of our camera as a doctor examined him. American David Eubank of the Free Burma Rangers was on location at the time training Kurdish Peshmerga soldiers.
We just don't know. Is it chlorine or is it mustard or is it something else? And that's why we need people to come and test this. The doctor was appealing. Please come, someone come and test so we know, one, what it is so we can treat our people, two, so we know how to guard against it if we get hit again.
Meanwhile, in London, another counterterrorism intelligence breakthrough. British intelligence MI6 has announced it has obtained a cache of names of ISIS recruits and their family members.
According to the Daily Mail, it's a treasure trove of information leaked by a disgruntled jihadi. 22,000 names, addresses, phone numbers, family contacts, and even the names of personal Islamic State recruiters, and it's all contained on a memory stick. The Mail reports the information is a goldmine of intelligence and the biggest ISIS intelligence haul ever uncovered. Gary Lane, CBN News.
Thank you, Gary. Well, some members of Congress are pushing the State Department to get tough on countries that allow human trafficking. They want the department to start with its own annual trafficking report because they say it often just glosses over policies that encourage trafficking. Heather Sells has the story.
Those who fight human trafficking say it's very clear. Countries that allow prostitution create a greater demand for human trafficking. That's why it's a problem when the State Department's annual report card on trafficking virtually ignores the legal sex trade. A bipartisan group of lawmakers wants to change that.
Our concern is sometimes it can be pushed away a little bit by our State Department when they want to pursue diplomacy with a certain nation. They might feel like bringing out the truth of what's going on with human trafficking might hurt diplomacy.
If Congress passes this law, it will affect countries like Spain, which right now receives a top rating from the U.S., despite the fact that the purchase of sex there is legal, and the Spanish government itself estimates that as many as 1 million purchases of sex are made every day.
It's really troubling. A country of about 47 million people who live in Spain, and yet 39% of men there say that they've purchased sex. 39%. It's just an unfathomable number.
Sponsor Randy Holtgren says U.S. influence matters and can encourage countries to improve their record. And if his efforts save even one child, he says it's all worth it. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Thanks, Heather. And Terry, this is such a bigger problem than people realize.
It really is. Those statistics are shocking.